economy by helping out creating new businesses, innovative new businesses in the ICT sector. I think Professor Hanouchi and other colleagues were extensively talking about innovation. They gave the definition of innovation. We see innovation in the context of IntiLab as any approach which is combining a lot of topics like science, technology, the financial, the commercial aspects, to come up with new products and create new jobs. This is the way we look to the, so basically generate or resulting new products. IntiLab was created, and we have now a fund of 28 million dinar. As Amar mentioned earlier on, maybe the biggest one in this context. It is helping out a business generator based on three principles. Firstly, we look to each and every entrepreneur's needs and try to help out. Starting from coaching, trainings, as well as and then going up to the level of funding. The funding is to an average of 250,000 dinar per startup, but we have cases where we injected 400,000 dinar. So this is the first principle. No one size fits all. It means we look to each and every individual need of the entrepreneur and try to help out with that mix, going up to the financing and money. This initiative is based on combining efforts from a lot of players in this field. So we try really to network and maximize value for entrepreneurs. And finally, end to end, as I told you, we look to the idea and go up to the funding. IntiLab has been initiated by Qatar Friendship Fund, Ooredoo, and Microsoft. There are many other partners. I don't want to go through them, but again, this refers to the point that we are really joining forces in order to maximize the value add. Internet of Things is in the core of what we are trying to push in Tunisia. And if you look to that Fraunhofer focus, it is a German institution, and I think it should be known to the colleagues active in research. These are the founders of the IoT standard. And these are our partners. When it comes to IoT, for example, they're providing an IoT framework, which is for free, accessible to anybody who wants to try out or to create projects around this. Let me spend 3 minutes to explain our approach of supporting entrepreneurs in Tunisia. You see that red square, that red bar, which is about startups. So we're putting startups in the core of what we're doing, and we're trying to feed teams who have created startups and connect them to the ecosystem around. So developers, other SMEs or startups, researchers, and students. We have, for example, this year over 25 TFEs, which we connected to the startups in order to help out creating the products. So we're connecting all these according to a structured process in order to help out any startup to emerge and create business. So basically, the framework of IntiLab is about a very good environment in order to meet people, have fun in implementing your startup idea and taking it to a level of product which you can sell. It's a place for ideation. We have many frameworks, development frameworks, which you can use to test your ideas for free. Here we have what we call the app factory, so we have many devices which you can get in order to test your application. We have experts who can help you to learn how to develop applications. And of course, as I told you, the IoT framework and many other tools. So with that, you can easily build your minimum viable product and finally get your funding. Let me just finish here with the results so far. We have 25 funded startups or engagement of funding of startups which are now active, and 3 which we recently have on board. These are all the startups. I'm not going to bother you with the details of what they are doing, but all of them are in the area of ICT. The activities of these startups, you see that some of them developed already and they are active, selling their products. Some of them are still in the development phase of their products. The impact which we are planning to achieve is can be measured by the revenue created by these startups. For 2015, we project that our portfolio of startups will generate a revenue of 1.9 billion dinar, which, and we are good on the way. I'm quite confident we're gonna make it happen. Of course, another indicator is the number of jobs created. We are now around 100 jobs created with these startups, and we want to take it up to the level of 200 staff only for these startups which are already active in our portfolio. Let me just maybe a very quick example. This is a startup which was born in a research lab in the University of Tunis. Some of which is dealing with sign language, so about translating voice to sign language, and we were able to get them out of the lab to create a startup and make a commercial product out of it. Well, the addressable market here is about 10 million. And by the way, for the sign language for the deaf, for the deaf people, it is specific to the initial language. So the Arabic sign language is not the same as the English and so on. So this would be a startup addressing the whole MENA region with this product. So some other numbers, 400 trained. We provide trainings free of charge. We provide certifications at very accessible prices, and some of them are for free. And important is we are present in both Sfax and Tunis. So for people who, of course, we would love to be present everywhere in Tunis, in Tunisia, but it is, of course, very difficult. In order to cope with that limitation, we partner with Paul Gazella. So, In remote areas where you need to be present, we are through Polo Gazella able to provide our services which are mentioned before. I don't want to take more time than that. So if you need any information about that, these are the contacts, and I will be after the session available for any one-to-one sessions. To take it further now, I started with my presentation first, but there are 3 other contributions which are very important and which are, I hope, will motivate you to take your ideas further and make business out of them. We have Ashraf from VistaPrint. VistaPrint is a company which started with 3 people, I think 3 founders. It's a big company now, 500 plus employees. So I would like to, this is a reference, this is a success story, and I would like to invite Ashraf to present, then we go to the other contributors. We conclude with a Q&A here in this session. So please.
Thank you, Mr. Well, hi everybody. So I can see after lunch, okay, so let's run that piece together. Thank you, first of all, for Netflix, because I'm really, let's say, surprised and happy and glad to say that the first session for me. And to see Tunisian people studying in the United States, North America, so doing a very good and great job outside Tunisia. And now we can say, and I'm sure that we have other people doing the same things outside Tunisia. And now we can say to all of us, to our students, that we are the same, that we are good and the right persons to support, let's say, the progress of our, let's say, country and progress of the future of our students. I would like to thank you again, and congratulations for what you did. Okay, so